I want to say first, thank you to Kelly and Arras and your entire team for bringing me here. This is such a fantastic experience. I got in yesterday afternoon and every moment of the way has just been so special and magical. So thank you for bringing me here.
Thank you so much for coming today. We're so excited to have Libby here with us today.
I am so excited to be here with Arras sisters today, meet Libby Moore, but as importantly, meet all of these women who are up and coming, and just network with them and find out what inspires them and what has helped drive them. I love that about Arras sisters, connecting with women all throughout the region and even throughout the country.
I've been fired twice, I think, and laid off once in my life, and I love talking about that because in hindsight, when I look back, I go, oh, that was the universe, God, whatever you call it, saying, okay, course correction. You don't need to be going down here. You need to go over here.
Arras creates opportunities for women.
My name is Diana Ford, and I'm super excited to be here. It's going to be really inspiring to hear Libby and what she has to say, but also just the networking. There's some phenomenal women in the room doing all kinds of different things, and I'm happy to be here as part of it.
What Arras does, bringing women, interesting women together in these unique experiences like this.
Being a part of Arras has been really special for me, starting my own business and feeling a part of a group of women who are here to empower one another.
You step into it and you figure it out and you ask questions and, you know, that those opportunities help you to just rise and evolve and rise and fall.
Arras creates opportunities for women. Today is a perfect example. Having Libby Moore here in St. Louis, Oprah's chief of staff, is so exciting, not just for the women in St. Louis community, but for everyone in St. Louis. I am so happy to be a part of it, and we're so lucky to have Kelly Hager bring Libby to us. We're grateful.
So had I been in that little insecure part of myself that thought, who am I to lead these people to Nelson Mandela's office? And you know what I mean? That would have been a disaster. And my energy would have been off and weird and wonky and, you know. So I just had to really get into alignment and step into the fullness of myself, which meant being confident and, you know, putting my shoulders back and bringing that energy.